Today's Sunshine Note is titled, A God Who Never Gives Up. A bruised reed he will not break, and a smothering wick he will not snuff off. Isaiah 42 verse 3. About 15 years ago, I started to make a quilt. I began enthusiastically selecting the fabrics from a craft store and hand-stitching the little squares. It was all going quite nicely, that is, until I got tired of it and gave up. Those hand-stitched squares now rest in a box in my closet. Then rollerblades were all the rage. I gave them a try. I had never ice skated or roller skated, so I started at the ground level on this. Literally, I actually had to learn the basics to keep myself from repeatedly landing on the ground. After one intense lesson with my athletic husband as my instructor, I abandoned the idea. It's tempting to give up on things when they start to look hopeless, but God isn't like us. In fact, the Bible says that He does not quit. He never ceases to see potential in situations. A prophecy describes this characteristic of Jesus. It sounds poetic and almost cryptic. A bruised reed will not break, and a smothering wick he will not snuff off. Isaiah was using images that would make sense to the people at that time. For example, a bruised reed referred to a large piece of grass that had been bent. Perhaps it was by the water's edge and an animal had stepped on it, or the wind had blown it down. Most people would think it would be crushed and broken from then on, but according to this prophecy, Jesus would not see it this way. A smoldering wick is also an image that was relatable to people at that time. To picture it yourself, think of a candle that is just about to go off. It has more smoke than flame and it looks as if it won't ignite again. Most people would expect the flame to completely die out, but according to the prophecy, Jesus would view it differently. Isaiah used these images to explain that Jesus won't give up on situations that appear hopeless. He won't break off a bruised reed because it wants it to grow back healthy. Nor will He snuff out a smoldering wick because He expects the flame to ignite again. When you face a seemingly hopeless situation, remember that God does not consider it hopeless. Live it out. Is there a situation in your life in which you have given up hope? After reading Isaiah 42 verse 3, do you think God has abandoned any hope? What can you do to reignite your hope? Pray about it. Ask God to help you see things how He does, full of potential. A bruised reed He will not break, and a smoldering wick He will not snuff out. Isaiah 42 verse 3. May God bless you today.